This is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. I will talk about the nerves on the posterior abdominal wall, and I will discuss the autonomic innervation of the abdominal viscera. So, on the posterior abdominal wall, we have the lumbar plexus and autonomic nerves. And these autonomic nerves are sympathetic nerves, parasympathetic, and autonomic plexuses, like the celiac, superior mesenteric, inferior mesenteric, and superior hypogastric plexus, and also renal plexus. So we'll talk about the lumbar plexus and the autonomic nerves. Regarding the lumbar plexus, okay, we'll talk about the location, the formation, and the branches. Actually, I don't see the lumbar plexus, but I see its branches because it is located inside the psoas major muscle. So the location of the lumbar plexus inside the psoas major muscle, it is formed by the ventral rami of the upper four lumbar nerves, L1 to L4. Regarding the branches of the lumbar plexus, it has muscular branches and six named branches. Muscular branches supply the muscles of the posterior abdominal wall, like psoas minor, psoas major, and quadratus lumborum. Remember, L1, 2, 3, and 4. L1 supplies psoas minor, and the 2, 3, and 4 supply psoas major, and all of them supply quadratus lumborum. So, muscular branches, psoas minor, L1, psoas major, L2, 3, and 4, quadratus lumborum, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Regarding the six named branches, six named branches, okay, this is the first one, iliohypogastric nerve from L1, and this one, ilioinguinal nerve from L1, this one, genitofemoral nerve from L1 and L2, this one, lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh from L2 and L3, and then femoral nerve from L2, 3, and 4, posterior division, and obturator nerve, L2, 3, and 4, anterior division. So these are the six named branches. Let us see them. So regarding the arrangement of the lumbar plexus, it is formed by the ventral rami of the upper four lumbar nerves, L1, L2, L3, and L4. L1 divides into three branches, or gives the three branches. First one, iliohypogastric. So iliohypogastric nerve from L1. Second branch, ilioinguinal. So ilioinguinal also is from L1. And another branch unites with a branch from L2. Okay, this branch unites with a branch from L2 to form genitofemoral nerve. So the genitofemoral nerve, the root value of the genitofemoral nerve is L1 and L2. Then L1, L2, L3 divide into anterior division and posterior division. Anterior division white, posterior division red. Anterior division, posterior division. Anterior division, posterior division. All the anterior divisions form the obturator nerve. All the posterior divisions form the femoral nerve. And then the posterior division of L2 and L3, this is the posterior division of L2 and L3, form the lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh. So the six branches, six named branches of the lumbar plexus, iliohypogastric from L1, ilioinguinal from L1, genitofemoral nerve, L1 and L2, lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh, L2 and L3, femoral nerve and obturator nerve, L2, 3 and 4. Femoral nerve, posterior division, obturator nerve, anterior division. And then the lower part of L4 unites with L5 to form the lumbosacral trunk, which enter in the formation of the sacral plexus. Regarding the relation of the branches of the lumbar plexus to the psoas major muscle, we have only one branch in front of the psoas major. This is the genitofemoral nerve. This genitofemoral nerve divides into genital branch and femoral branch. Then four branches along its lateral border, from above downward, iliohypogastric nerve, then ilioinguinal nerve, then lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh, and the femoral nerve in the groove between psoas and the iliacus. Along the medial side, we have this branch, obturator nerve, and L4 unites with L5 to form lumbosacral trunk. L4, L5, lumbosacral trunk. Regarding the autonomic innervation of the abdominal viscera, we have sympathetic nerves, 4, and the parasympathetic. Regarding the 4 sympathetic nerves, 3 coming from the thorax and 1 coming from the abdomen. Greater splanchnic nerve to the foregut. This greater splanchnic nerve arises from T5 to T9 ganglia. Second one, lesser splanchnic nerve, it supplies the midgut, arises from T9 and T10. And the lowest splanchnic nerve supplies the kidney, arises from T12 ganglion. So these splanchnic nerves arise from the thorax, arise in the thorax and enter the abdomen. And in the abdomen, lumbar splanchnic nerve to the hind gut from L1 and L2 ganglia. So sympathetic nerves are 4, greater splanchnic nerve to the foregut, lesser splanchnic nerve to the midgut, lowest splanchnic nerve to the kidney, and the lumbar splanchnic nerve to the hind gut. Remember, refer the pain from the foregut radiates to dermatomes T5 to T9. And refer the pain from the midgut radiate to dermatomes T10 and T9 and T10. And refer the pain from the kidney radiates to dermatome 12. And refer the pain from the hind gut radiates to dermatomes L1 and L2. Regarding parasympathetic nerves, we have 2. The vagus. This vagus nerve supplies the foregut and the midgut via the celiac and the superior mesenteric plexus. The hind gut and the ureter are supplied by the pelvic splanchnic nerves from S2, 3, and 4. So parasympathetic innervation of the abdominal viscera, vagus, and the pelvic splanchnic nerves. Vagus, foregut, and the midgut. Pelvic splanchnic nerves, hind gut, and ureter. So these are the nerves innervating the viscera. Just reminding you of the abdominal splanchnic nerves arising from the thorax. Greater splanchnic, lesser splanchnic, and lowest splanchnic. This is a sympathetic chain. Sympathetic ganglia from 1 to 12. Number 11 might be absent. So the first one, greater splanchnic nerve. This greater splanchnic nerve supplies the foregut, arises from T5 to T9. Second one, lesser splanchnic nerve supplying the midgut, arises from T9 and T10. And the last one, lowest splanchnic nerve supplying the kidney, that's why it's called the renal nerve, arising from T12. Regarding the autonomic plexuses, the first one is the celiac plexus around the celiac artery. Superior mesenteric plexus around the superior mesenteric artery. Inferior mesenteric plexus around the inferior mesenteric artery. And the superior hypogastric plexus in front of the bifurcation of the abdominal aorta. And I can add renal plexus along the renal artery. Okay? Celiac plexus around the celiac artery. It is formed by the greater splanchnic nerve and the celiac ganglion plus branches from the vagus. Superior mesenteric plexus formed by around the superior mesenteric artery, formed by lesser splanchnic nerve and the superior mesenteric ganglion plus the vagus. Inferior mesenteric plexus around the inferior mesenteric artery, formed by lumbar splenic nerves and inferior mesenteric ganglion plus pelvic splenic nerves parasympathetic. How about the superior hypogastric plexus in front of the bifurcation of the abdominal aorta, and actually it is the continuation of the inferior mesenteric plexus. Renal plexus around the renal artery, the formed by lowest splenic nerve and renal ganglion supplies the kidney. And thank you very much. Good luck and best wishes.